We get stressed, so do animals. Shortage of food, water, conflicts with their neighbors, infections, predators, temperature fluctuations can all cause them stress. Even humans and human activities, stressed animals suffer just as much as humans do. Can we find out the animals that are under stress and help reduce it?
Animals can show a wide spectrum of behavior when they are under stress, but they cannot communicate with us directly. It is also extremely difficult to follow them and study their behavior under natural conditions without disturbing them. But there are other ways to monitor and even measure stress. You must have noticed that when we are stressed, our bodies get warm, we sweat, and our heartbeat increase. That happens because the glands in our bodies produce glucocorticoid hormones. These are steroid molecules. They are secreted into our bloodstream and help us face difficult situations. This happens also in animals. So, presence of steroids in blood can thus be used as an indicator of stress. This is the strategy Dr. Umapathy and his team use at the Laboratory for Conservation of Endangered Species in the Center for Cellular and Molecular Biology. This is great, but there is still one problem. Generally, blood samples are used, but getting blood samples from wild animals is challenging for researchers and stressful for the animals. So, Dr. Umapathy's team has devised an alternative. They have found that stress-indicating steroids are not only present in the blood of these animals, but also in their hair and feces. Animals leave these biological samples in their environments. So, instead of sticking a needle into the animals, they can simply collect their hair or feces for testing steroids. Using such a technique, they found that cows in crowded shelter houses are under stress due to old age, poor feeding practices, less space per cow, improper flooring, and unhygienic conditions. The elephants used in religious processions also show high stress levels compared to other captive elephants. Tigers in natural reserves are found to be stressed because of increased tiger tourism and other human activities such as building highway traffic roads, cattle grazing, human inhabitation. Stress impacts growth, reproduction, and immunity of animals, eventually impacting their survival. Therefore, we need to correct our actions. When we build shelters for these animals, we should create stress-free spaces for them. We could avoid using elephants, especially the young females in their reproductive years, in religious processions or for rides. We could reduce human-centric developmental activities, vehicular and human traffic in protected areas of the forest. These studies can help us in sustainable development where humans, animals and other life forms can coexist and flourish.